हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल सी द फेजर रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन वोल्टेज, करंट एंड फ्लक्स इन द डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रिकल सर्किट। वी विल डिराइव द रिलेशनशिप, फेजर रिलेशनशिप, यूजिंग द मैथमेटिकल एक्सप्रेशन इन दिस वीडियो। सो लेट गेट स्टार्टेड विद द सिंपलेस्ट ऑफ सर्किट, दैट इज रेजिस्टिव सर्किट। सिंपल रेजिस्टिव सर्किट दैट इज alternating source Vs is applied across a resistance R and a current IR is shown. So we here Vs is an alternating source. We can write it as Vm sin omega t, and by Ohm's law, this is first equation, by Ohm's law we know that I is equal to V upon R. So IR will be equal to Vm upon R sin omega t. So this is first equation for voltage, this is second equation for current. We see that phase angle of both voltage and current is same, that is omega t. So here we can say that through this equation that voltage and current when flowing through a resistive circuit are always in same phase. If I draw the phasor diagram of voltage here, suppose then phasor diagram of current will also be in same phase. This is a simple circuit of a resistance. Now second one is pure inductive circuit. Okay. This is a voltage source Vs flowing through a inductor L, current is IL. We all the Ohm's law for inductor circuit is given by V is equal to L di by dt. So let us suppose here IL is equal to I sin omega t. So therefore V is equal to L into d sin omega t upon d omega t, that is equal to L cos omega t, or we can write this as L sin omega t plus 90. This is the equation of Vs voltage, and this is the equation of voltage, this is the equation of current. So comparing this to equation, we see that IL is, when IL is at omega t, Vs is at omega t plus 90. So in inductive circuit, voltage leads the current by 90 degree, or we can say that current lags voltage by 90 degree. So if you draw a phasor diagram for a inductor, it will be like this. If you draw voltage here, then current will be 90 degree. This is the current, phasor diagram of current. So now next, moving on to the next type of circuit, that is the capacitive circuit or capacitive circuit. Here we will draw a simple circuit of voltage source applied across a capacitance C, current is IC. Here voltage source, let us suppose Vs is Vm sin omega t. Now for Ohm's, according to the Ohm's law of or capacitance, current flowing IC is equal to C dv by dt, dv upon d omega t. So that is C d upon d omega t of v m sine omega t, that is v m cos omega t, or we can write c v m sine omega t plus 90 degree. This is the equation of IC. So this is first equation of voltage, which is Vm sin omega t, and current for the same capacitance is Vm sin omega t plus 90. So we can see that the phase angle of IC leads the phase angle of voltage by 90 degree. So in a pure capacitive circuit, if you draw the voltage here, let us say voltage here, current will lead voltage by an angle 90 degree. This is for a capacitive circuit. Now the fourth one come for relationship between flux and current flowing through a coil. We know that whenever a current flows through a coil, a flux is generated. Now what is the relationship between the what is the phasor relationship between a flux and current? So let us draw a simple diagram, simple circuit. This is a current source, it is connected to a coil. Suppose current flowing here is I, this number of turns of number of n is the number of turns, and phi is the flux generated by current source or current. We know that whenever current flows through a coil, an MMF is generated. MMF is equal to number of turns into amplitude of current, and by Ohm's law of magnetic force, we know that MMF is equal to flux into reluctance. From this equation we can write that Ni is equal to phi RL, or phi is equal to N upon RL into I. Now if I is equal to I sine omega t, then phi will be equal to N upon RL I sine omega t. So this is the value of, this is the phase of current, and this is the phase of the flux which the current has generated. So we see that the phasor difference between the current and the flux which is generated is zero. Both are at omega t. So if you have to draw a diagram of any phasor of any current, suppose I, and the flux which is created, then the flux will also be in same direction. Now the next part is flux and back EMF. Now similarly, when a flux cuts through a coil, a back EMF is generated. So what is the phasor relationship between the flux and the back EMF which is generated? Now as per Faraday law, we know that EMF generated through any coil is equal to minus N d phi by dt. This negative sign is here in accordance to the Lenz law, which says opposes the cause. Here cause is flux, so it opposes the EMF, opposes the cause. Now let us assume phi is equal to phi m sine omega t. So EMF E will be equal to minus N d phi m sine omega t upon d omega t, that is equal to minus n cos omega t, or we can write that minus n sin nine t minus omega t. This can also be written as n sin omega t minus 90. If you take the negative sign inside, it is n sin omega t minus 90. Now this is the equation of flux, and this is the equation of EMF which this flux has generated. We see that EMF lags the flux by an angle 90 degree. So we can draw the diagram as, whenever a flux flows through a coil, an alternating flux flows through a coil phi, the EMF which is generated lag 90 degree behind it. This is the EMF. So we have seen the all different relationship between phasor and voltage in different types of circuits. Hope this will help you. Thank you.